Today, we'll talk about which are the 5 best picks, how to choose the correct product, and what you should look at before buying. We've ranked these products based on their price, quality, durability, performance, and more. If you'd like to see their price and find out more information, you can check out the links in the description down below. Let's get started. If quality is your main focus, then you should consider this next model because it has the best build quality.
Number 5, Logitech Z623. The Logitech Z623 is designed for gaming, packed with loads of power, and quite easily is our top pick among all gaming speakers. This 2.1 speaker setup is so much more than just an average satellite and subwoofer combination. If you don't mind the high 200 watt power requirement, the Z623 will serve you well for years to come. HX certification is stringent and not all speakers can achieve the high performance standards to get one, but when a speaker does receive THX certification, it means the speakers are capable of doing much more than just gaming. With ample power, thunderous bass and performance at par with the best, these speakers bring out realism in games. Music, movies and recordings all seem so much more studio quality with power that just does not stop. Keep increasing the volume or the bass as you need to for an immersive audio. The Z623, however, works on 200 watts of power to ensure you never compromise on loudness or clarity. These speakers are THX certified with a deep resounding bass that rattles your bones with precision. The Logitech Z623 uses quick access RCA and 3.5mm input and can take a total of 3 audio inputs. It also has a headphone jack if you ever need it. By the way, the subwoofer is rated at 130 watts, so go easy on the controls unless you want to shatter the peace in your neighborhood playing Battlefield. Small and yet powerful speakers, a large 130 watt subwoofer with precision 2.1 surround sound effect ensures that the Z623 behaves less like a dual speaker setup and more like a 3D 7.1 speaker setup. Gaming on these babies is just incredible, and playing music or watching a movie is as good as the big screen.
Next up, we have a model which gives you the best value for your money.
Number 4, Creative Labs GigaWorks T22. Although 2.1 speakers seem to be the standard for desktop PC audio solutions, that doesn't mean that this is the best option. It's possible to get great sound out of a 2.1 set, but often you end up with a distinct lack of cohesion due to a poor quality crossover and overbearing subwoofer. That's why, given the choice, a really good set of 2.0 speakers will always provide a better all-round soundstage. These GigaWorks T20s from Creative represent the very best that the company has to offer, since the GigaWorks brand is saved for only the best, or as Creative might put it, the discerning listener. On the front of the right channel speaker are bass, treble and volume controls, as well as headphone jack and auxiliary in for easy connection to an MP3 player. A 0.5m mini jack cable is included for this function, with a separate 2m 3.5mm cable for connection to a PC. Also included in the box is a twin phono to 3.5mm adapter, making connecting a games console or other device easy. On the back are the audio input, left speaker output and AC in. Although they sound magnificent when turned up at high, at moderate, what one might consider normal levels, the effect is less impressive. They still sound great with good clarity and a nice balance, but the bass is rather subdued and must be turned up to the full to achieve an optimal balance. Gaming performance was equally impressive. In general, I prefer headphones for gaming, but those who like to use their speakers will find the T20s more than capable of getting the job done. Certainly, the best feature of these speakers is, however, the price. They're an absolute steal for a great set of desktop speakers that look good too. Obviously, if you're prepared to spend a lot of money, you'll find better sounding speakers utilizing multiple channels, but at this price, the T20s represent superb value. They're more convenient than 2.1 systems with even less wiring to deal with, and in many cases, will sound better too.
If you're looking for a mid-range model, then this next pick is a great option.
Number 3, Razer Leviathan. Razer historically has been a peddler of pointers and the king of keyboards. Just look at the venerable Black Widow or Death Adder. The Leviathan is many things for Razer. It's Razer's first soundbar, mainly, but also its first step into your living room and the consoles that live there. It's the first product from Razer that can directly interface with your Xbox One and PS4 via its optical audio in port, as well as your PC or TV through auxiliary in. But more than any of these, the Leviathan represents an idea. Companies like Razer can do and become more than ever before. Best described as an all-black half-size soundbar, the Leviathan measures in at 19.7 by 3 by 2.8 inches and comes in around 4.5 pounds. Don't let its dimensions throw you, it's similarly sized to other entry-level soundbars, and it produces more than enough sound to compensate for its diminutive stature. Looking at the top of the bar, you'll find standard controls as well as the Bluetooth button used to sync the Leviathan up with your mobile device and a preset button that switches between game, music and movie modes. Spin it all the way around to find a proprietary subwoofer out, DC in, optical audio in and auxiliary in jacks as well as two brackets for wall mounting. As it stands though, the subwoofer is one of Leviathan's greatest assets. This little box pushes an astounding amount of air through its 5.25 inch driver and produces a rich bass-heavy sound that doesn't distort at its highest volume. I found the low end a little too overpowering for my taste, but if you're a gamer that likes your bass to drop harder than the bodies of your opponents, you'll no doubt come to love the little cube. Besides a few balancing issues, the overall quality of the Leviathan's sound is good no matter which input you decide to use. The Dolby Pro Logic 2 codec will transform any signal, analog, optical or Bluetooth, to be simulated 5.1 surround sound. It has to be simulated though, as the unit is one driver shy of true 5.1 sound. But in spite of its diminutive size, the Leviathan far outgrew our expectations.
Before we talk about the best model overall, let's look at the runner-up for this list.
Number 2. Klipsch Pro Media 2.1. Though not originally made for gaming, the Klipsch Pro Media 2.1 does hold its own in the world of first-person shooters and real-time strategies. However, that's not why you should buy this speaker. You should because of the price tag and the fact that you get a THX-certified 10-year-old model that continues to gain in popularity even today. These are easily the best 2.1 surround sound speakers currently on the market. The Klipsch Pro Media 2.1 is a three-piece audio system primarily designed for desktop usage as an audio entertainment center. It's THX certified with two satellite speakers, each delivering full stereo sound using 35-watt drivers. For deep rumbling low frequencies, it uses a 130-watt subwoofer that can reach 31 Hz without bottoming out. The satellites each use Klipsch's proprietary micro Tractix horns that help maintain clarity regardless of the audio source. You can stream from internet radio, play MP3 or CDs, and this speaker will sound the same. It relies on a hybrid digital amplifier capable of high output that can even power an expensive monitor headphone or the dual stereo analog inputs. Gaming on these speakers is an amazing experience. THX or not, the speakers are fuller than normal 2.1 surround sound units. Yes, spatial differentiation is limited to the left and right zones, but with the power the satellite speakers possess, it's not hard figuring out a bit more than just the direction. If there's one thing that we dislike in the Klipsch Pro Media 2.1, it's the back DIN connectors to the subwoofer. They're not well designed and may eventually fail. It works great with everything. Forget gaming, even low quality audio files sound better on this THX certified speaker set. Yes, the subwoofer eats over 130 watts, but in return, it never fails to power through a demanding mix of highs, lows, and bass.
Finally, the next model is the best overall. From us, it gets a perfect score in all categories.
Number 1. Logitech G560. With more than two decades of experience making speakers, we had some very high expectations for Logitech's G560. They might not be the best for the modern audiophile, but we can confidently say these are the most immersive speakers we've tested for gaming. The G560 features six high-powered RGB LEDs per speaker, four facing the rear and two for the front. At maximum brightness, they can be a little distracting in a dark room, but a nifty button at the top of the right speaker lets you tone it down or turn them off completely. A pleasant rainbow color cycle works as the default mode, but jumping into Logitech gaming software is when the magic happens. The software allows you to choose between two control modes for the speakers. Hardware control ditches the software and uses Bluetooth or AUX input devices for lighting. You get the same rainbow color cycle that also acts as an audio visualizer that flashes and brightens to the beat of the music being played. Switching over to software control allows you to choose between fixed color, color cycle, breathing, audio visualizer, and screen sampler. Screen sampler is where the G560 really shines. Much like ambient backlighting products, the software takes user-defined areas of the screen and extends the colors outwards to create a very immersive lighting experience. These speakers won't provide the same experience the Hue 2 Ambient will provide, but it's a great start. However, since a good portion of this effect relies on the rear-facing LEDs, the speakers need to be positioned right beside your display with their back against the wall to get the best effect. Like most brands creating RGB peripherals, Logitech has an SDK that allows developers to fully utilize the G560 lighting. As of this writing, several popular titles already feature game integration such as League of Legends, Fortnite, Battlefield 1, Dota 2, CSGO, GTA 5, and a few others. The G560 comes with a very powerful down-firing subwoofer, which proved to be amazing for things like explosions, but became quite overpowering at low volumes while listening to music. Adjustments in the software help a little, but you're on your own if you're connected to Bluetooth. Buying guide. Firstly, check your PC specs. Not all computers can handle a 5.1 surround set of speakers. If your PC's motherboard supports the 5.1 system, the front cable of the speakers should go into the port labeled line out, the rear cable into the rear out, and subwoofer cable into the subwoofer out. Otherwise, you have to use the other ports to be able to enjoy the 5.1 system. The front cable will have to go to the line out, the rear to the line in, the subwoofer to the mic in. Then configure the PC software to set the speaker output to 6-channel mode. Secondly, the features you need. 2 channels, left and right speakers, are usually enough if you just want an improvement from the PC's built-in speakers. However, if you want to hear, better yet feel, the lowest or highest frequencies, consider getting a subwoofer. Just note that though, an external sub takes up space, so again, check how big you can go. Check the power. A speaker's wattage is directly proportional to the loudness your speakers can give. If you want to drown out the outside noise, then choose speakers with a higher wattage. But if it's just for you to hear the usual bangs, thumps, and orchestra playing in your games, a 40-watt speaker will do. And lastly, budget. Money talks, as the adage goes. This is true in almost every aspect. Thus, when buying gaming speakers, you have to know how much your pocket can shell out. 5.1 and 7.1 speakers are usually on the higher end of the price spectrum, so it's the 2.1 channel that's often budget-friendly. Good thing technology has given us plenty of options these days. You can get a soundbar which comes in 2.1, 5.1 or 7.1 channels without creating a big hole in your pocket. Thanks for watching. I hope you liked the video. If you found it helpful, please remember to leave a like and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this in the future. If you have any questions related to these products, you can leave a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.